Welcome to the amazing episode of Magnets and Jello. We are going to have a lot of fun today trying to figure out what happens with Jello and how that affects magnetism. So you're going to see that we have a lot of variety of options to work with today. The first thing that you want to find around your home is anything that's magnetic. If you're not sure if something's magnetic or not, the best thing you can do is find your refrigerator. And let's see if we can find some magnets that are on that refrigerator. So I've picked two from my refrigerator right here. I have also enlisted the help of this special magnet, and I have it in this case just so that it doesn't get too messy from all the stuff that we're gonna do. This is a neodymium magnet, which is a rare earth magnet. These are very, very powerful magnets. So I'm gonna set it by my other magnets out of the screen here. And if you want to check for some items, I would actually maybe look for some washers and some nails. So I found this nail right here, and I can kind of check to make sure that it's magnetic. So we're going to make sure that it actually is attracted to the magnet. Oh, and it is. That's excellent. So that would be a great tool to use today for studying magnetism. And then I also found a washer as well. So if I want to check to see if that's going to work for our experiments today, I'm going to take that magnet next to it, and you can see that it is very easily attracted to it. The neodymium is very, very strong, so let's see that strong attraction to it. And you can even hear it as well. You can hear, more of that force. And then it's really hard to pull them apart, so I kind of try to slide them back and forth. The other thing that you can find, too, which you can find at your local hardware store, are actually some iron filings. So if you can find this iron metal, I had some actually in my chemical storage room. It's really kind of nice because we're going to look at how things actually move maybe as a whole. One of the items that I looked at when I was a teacher in the research experience for teachers program was how certain cells are attracted or repelled by different stiffnesses of polymers. So instead of using polymers, we're actually going to use Jello today, and we're going to study what happens as the Jello sets and becomes harder. What's going to happen to the magnetism, or the ability of something to be attracted to a magnet? So one of the things that you'll also want to find in your home are some thread. You can use any kind of string. I'm sure you have some old pencils laying around. You can make your own Jello if you would like to, which is actually kind of the fun part because we're going to look at it as the Jello sets over time. Or you can just buy a package of some preset Jello too as well. This won't allow you to study it over time, but it will allow you to maybe make some experiments and some engineering designs to kind of see how much Jello it takes before my item is not attracted to my magnet anymore. So one of the things that we're going to look at is the iron filings, and I actually, this Jello has just been made recently, so you're going to notice on here the viscosity of this Jello. This is super loose in here, so very low resistance to flow, and it hasn't set yet. I only made it about half an hour ago. So you're going to notice on the bottom of this are some iron filings, and so let's kind of take a look at this and what happens to it when we place a magnet next to it. So I've zoomed in on the camera here, and I'm going to kind of hold the top of the cup so it doesn't move too much. And I'm going to take just a refrigerator magnet just to kind of see what happens. I'm going to kind of place it on the side here. I don't really see anything going on. Place it at the back here. I don't see a lot of attraction. Maybe we'll try at the top up here without touching that Jello. Don't really see anything. Go to the side here. Not really much is happening. And then let's actually bring it kind of in front here. And you start to notice that we see a little bit of attraction. So I'm gonna put it pretty close in here. And you can see that one of the metal filings is very attracted to this magnet. And actually, I can actually get it to move kind of around the cup. I'm gonna go all the way around here. I gotta switch hands. I don't have super long arms. And we can see that we can get that to go all the way back. And now you see I've actually attracted more of the iron filings up here, which is really kind of cool. It almost looks like a little transformer. And it's interesting to see the shapes that it kind of makes as it is attracted to that magnet. So I'm going to let the magnet sit there just for a second. And then let's go ahead and take it around to the front here. And then let's see if we can't take a second magnet up top. Let's see if we get any more attraction now that this is a little bit closer. But it doesn't look like we can. So let's try a really strong neodymium magnet and kind of see what happens, just as an experiment. And you start to see, ooh, a little bit of movement, and then bang, we got some strong attraction there. So that's really cool. So you can kind of experiment with that. And this would be before the Jello has actually set. So this is going to get harder and harder as we let the Jello set up correctly. So you might want to attempt this over maybe half an hour intervals. So every half an hour, go ahead, take your magnets, and let's see what kind of movement we can kind of get with that. You know, how close does the magnet actually have to be? So if you look on here, I can kind of make my little man move. Again, it looks like a little transformer, and I'm not as close there. And now I'm super close. They're very attracted to it. You can also test it with the neodymium magnet as well. So you're going to see the neodymium magnet. I'm not holding it as close. It's got a much stronger field of attraction. You can also notice the way the filings kind of line up. Okay. You might notice some symmetry in there. So I might try again and see, well, what if I bring it over here? Do they line up the same way? Ooh, I kind of do see that same kind of lineup every time I put this magnet next to it. And this is that really strong neodymium magnet. You notice everything kind of takes this linear shape with it. Here, we could also play with something that's not iron filings. So I have another cup. Again, this is that Jello that's not really set. And what I'm going to do is actually take a pencil. And with this pencil, I have a little bit of tape on the end, and I have actually taken some thread and thread it through my nut right here. And so what I'm going to do is actually attach this and kind of roll it on the tape so I can get it so that it's suspended really nicely into that Jello. The really nice thing about having this on tape is if I lower it into here and I feel like it's just not low enough, I can actually just pull on the string just a little bit, make it a little bit deeper. If I go too deep, I can actually back it back up again. And now we see that this is suspended in there. And this is a little bit different than the iron because I can actually play around with where this is at in here. Again, this Jello has not set yet. So again, lots of movement in here. And I'm going to start to bring this magnet around. And you can see that it's very attracted to the item in the middle. In fact, as I kind of move it, I can actually get this to spin a little bit. Okay, and I'm not very close to it. So I'm outside of that cup line. I'm not even touching the cup. And then let's see what the neodymium magnet does to it. And we can see a ton of movement. I can go around. We're going to notice this is a very strong magnet, so it's going to have a nice force of attraction. I might even move my item all the way to the back of the cup. I'm going to hold the top of the cup because the cup might move. And I'll place this at the front, and we'll see if we can get any attraction. Looks like I can't, so evidently that's going to be too far away. And maybe I'll start to move this around the side of the cup to see where it is before I get that attraction to it. So what we're going to do now is wait for our Jello to set a little bit longer. And we're going to see what happens when that Jello has set, if we can get the same kind of movement in both of these cups as well. If you are anything like me, you don't want to wait for it to set. And you might want to start experimenting with some other design ideas so that you can test out some magnetism. So what I'm going to do is take one of these preset Jellos, and I'm going to open up a couple of them for some different colors. I would also kind of grab a pan just so that mom or dad doesn't get upset that you have now made a Jello mess in your kitchen. But if I'm your mama, I'll be pretty happy that you're making a Jello mess for engineering in the kitchen. And then you can take kind of butter knife. If you want to, you can go around the outside edges of it, and let's see if we can't loosen that Jello to get out of there. We're actually going to cut these in different sizes, and we'll do the same thing again kind of with the blue as well. I'll take that one out, and we'll do the same thing with the red. So this is where your imagination is really the only thing stopping you. So one of the first designs that I tried was cutting each of these in half. So I'm going to cut these actually in half horizontally. Start with the blue one. We actually get some nice colored pieces. And I'm going to stack these kind of on top of each other. It's not really an even cut, but that's okay. I'm just experimenting. And we'll get the red one here. Kind of cut, try to cut straight. But so one of the things that you can do, which I thought was really interesting, was was to actually flip these two over on here. And what's really neat is we can kind of put them together and we can kind of see a gradient here where we can see the two different colors. If the red seems like you can't see through it as much, we can go ahead and put that orange one right on top here. And we can see some pretty neat movement in here. So the one thing that I'm going to try is I'm going to take some of my iron metal and I'm going to take the top off of this and we'll zoom in on this. And let's just see what happens. And we'll just put maybe a couple of pieces. I'm going to use my fingers and get just a few just so we can see it really easily. Here's a few little iron pieces. And remember, this Jello is actually set. So it's going to be a lot tougher for it to move through it. And then I'm going to place this other one on top of it. And then if we kind of zoom in here, one thing you can do is actually grab a paper plate, which is what I have, and we're going to set it on the plate so we can look at it and see what's going on. So one thing that I noticed is that when I picked two colors, and this is a great thing to experiment with, I couldn't really see through it very well. And so I've chosen the same color. So there's my little iron filings on there. And let's kind of see what happens to those as we place just a regular magnet on top. You can even try it onto the sides. So we're noticing that there's really not a ton of movement in those iron filings. So even though this magnet right here, it's exerting a force and they're attracted to each other, it's just not strong enough to overcome how strong the layers of the Jello are. We know it's attractive because we saw it before. So then let's try a little bit stronger of a magnet. So I'm going to try this. I'm going to kind of hold this neodymium magnet to see. Oh, and I actually felt one move because I could hear it. Let's go again. And it looks like we're getting a little bit of movement. So let's see if we can't see that from a side angle. Let's try our neodymium magnet again to see if we can get some movement in there. Ooh, we did see some movement. That's actually kind of cool. And we'll go to the other side here. We'll see how close we need to get to it. And you can start to see that attraction, which is really cool. So you can experiment with different sizes in terms of cutting the Jello.